Hello everyone, this is Dude Blender, and let's jump right in. I did travel photography back in the day, and many things that I learned in real life photography apply in Blender. The lens type lets you choose between perspective, orthographic, and panoramic. Perspective mimics the way we see things in real life, where objects that are further away appear smaller. This is the lens type that you will be using most of the time. You can select the focal length, which is how zoomed the image will be. The higher the number, the more zoom. And 50 millimeters is approximately what the human eye can see. Orthographic disregards the distortive effect of distance, so this lens will always show you the real size of things. Zooming in doesn't exist as a concept in orthographic, but you can change the orthographic scale to modify the field of view of the camera. The stylized effect that this lens provides is often used to make isometric rooms with qualities of cuteness and coziness. Panoramic cameras heavily distort the image and allows you to create some interesting effects. You'll mostly want to use this one when making fisheye or tiny planet renders. Note that these can only be used in cycles. Shift X and Y allow you to shift the camera without changing the perspective. This is useful in very specific cases where your frame composition is good, but you're missing an important element that is outside of the frame and you don't want to change the perspective. Here we can see the difference in physically moving the camera and shifting it. Clip start and end is the distance range that the camera will see. Everything outside this range will not be rendered. The camera panel provides options to change the size and fit of the sensor. The sensor fit just defines whether you fix the horizontal or vertical dimension when you change the resolution. If I set it to vertical, then changing the X or Y resolutions of the render keeps the vertical dimension fixed. Setting it to horizontal will keep the horizontal dimension fixed. Auto will change whichever dimension is smaller. So for example here, the X resolution is smaller, so changing X or Y resolution will adjust the horizontal dimension of the frame. But as soon as X becomes larger than Y, then it starts adjusting the vertical dimension. The size defines the size of the sensor that Blender is simulating. The default size is 36 millimeters, which is considered a full frame sensor in real life photography. Anything smaller than that is called crop sensor, and anything bigger is considered specialist and not something that you usually find except in cinematic and big budget productions, in formats like IMAX, for example. You can change this if you want to match your renders and animations with real life footage and you want to use the same sensor and lens to get the exact same perspective. For most projects, though, you'll want to leave it as it is. Safe areas adds an outline in the camera view around the areas of the frame that might be cut. This is actually quite useful if you make content for Instagram or TikTok, where parts of your image might not be visible in the frame in some platforms or device sizes. I think that the 16:9 preset works well enough to make sure that important elements like text or captions fall within these boundaries to guarantee that they will be visible in most devices. Center cut safe areas adds a second pair of boundaries. For most creators, though, I think that using only one boundary as reference is enough. Background images adds an image or clip when you see through the camera view. It can be in the front or in the back of your objects, and you can stretch it, fit it or crop it, as well as move it, rotate it, or flip it. This image will not show up in your render, so you can use it as a reference mostly if you want to match the perspective of an external image. For example, if you want to make a composition of a Blender element on a photograph. The viewport display panel has some useful options to visualize the camera properties. Size changes the size of the camera in the scene. This doesn't affect your render at all. It's just for you to be able to see the camera in an adequate size for your scene. Limits adds a visual marker of the clip start and end that you can change in the lens panel we saw earlier. This way you can see where it will start cropping. You can press Alt-Z to go to X-ray mode to see it. Mist adds a visual cue of the mist pass. The pass needs to be enabled first in the layer properties tab, passes panel, under the data menu. Then the actual range is in the world tab in the mist panel. Since it's a render pass, if you want to use it, you need to go to the compositing workspace. Check the use nodes box. Click on the backdrop button if it's not already on and connect the mist pass to a viewer node. If you don't see anything, it's because there is no render data to show, so render the scene. Now you can see the path data. To apply it to your image, you can add a mix node and set it to screen and connect the image to the mist pass. Sensor shows the sensor size in the camera view. Name displays the name of the camera, also in camera view. Passepartout darkens everything outside of the frame in the camera view, and the number defines how dark it looks. Composition guides adds an overlay of different composition theories. I made a short video about that, and I also leave it in the description. Depth of field will blur objects sits outside of the focal range. Focus object allows you to indicate on which object the camera will focus, or you can type a fixed distance. It's best to create an empty and train the camera on that empty so that you can easily control the focus. Aperture parameters define how Blender will simulate the characteristics of the lens. F-stop is how wide the lens diaphragm opens. The lower the number, the wider the aperture. Lower apertures provide a shallower depth of field. In real life, typical f-stops range from 1.2 to 16. Blades simulates the number of blades that the lens diaphragm has. This has an impact on the visual quality of objects that are out of focus, also called bokeh. In real life, more expensive lenses tend to have more blades. Rotation sets the rotation of the lens diaphragm. Ratio provides a distortion on objects that are out of focus. I also have a short video describing the f-stop in this link. And that's it for today. Drop a like, comment, and subscribe if you liked the video. Connect with me on TikTok and Instagram with the handle @DudeBlender. I'm Dude Blender. Happy blending.